Push P. Yeah, Push P, turn me up.
What's up, everybody? Welcome to my new video. Today, we got a little bit of a change. I'm trying to change the workflow, you know, just a little bit. This is my GitHub. Apparently, I made it a long time ago. Everything's public on here. I need to, like, fix it up. I don't even have a profile picture or anything like that. I need to verify. Do you verify yourself? I think. I don't know. I need to check it out. I need to go through, like, all the settings and stuff. But, yeah, this is my GitHub. I thought of something. I was like, man, I'm doing all these exercises. HTML and CSS. And JavaScript. I want some sort of history where I can see. Now, the first thing that came to mind was CodeCamp. But I noticed that CodeCamp, let me see if I could pull it up. My bad, it's called CodePen.io. I noticed that CodePen is more visual. Because, like, see, right here, I want to say, like I said, I want to save my JavaScript. And if you go to, like, just a general CodePen, let me see, trending, like, just normal. It's mostly visual. That's why there's, like, a little preview, you know? A lot of them are really good, and I think most of them are free. It's just uploaded by, like, they're not licensed. You can license them if you have the pro account. Damn, look at these views, bro. So if you're visual, I mean, this is recommended, right? Because you get hella views. Or it could depend. Damn, 34 views. 2006. So that's what's trending. Why is this one trending? Because it's a whole website? Maybe. Maybe whole website? Damn. Okay, so then I guess just one. Hover me. Let's try this one out. And you can see all the code that they use and stuff. That's simple. Yeah, that's... I was just about to say it. I completely forgot it, but I was just about to say you can do that with CSS. I want a place to save everything. Not only for me, but like for people that want to work. Because eventually I do want to sell as a service. Like I want to build websites. So eventually, you know, this will be a nice history. Imagine all this was green. That'd be nice. But it's not. But it is day one, so I ain't tripping. Day one. Time goes by fast, bro. Like, it's already been a year since I made this. I just started a new one. I'm on chapter 45. So, see, time does go by fast. Like, I'm already chapter 45, and it's been less than a month, I believe. So, let's see. To add a space between cell and text. This is still tables, right? Yeah, tables. Space between cell text and borders? Ain't that just margin, bro? Padding. Oh, yeah. My bad. Margin is outside. On the other side of the border. Padding is on the inside of the border. I forgot about that. To add spacing between cells. Wait, what was number one? On the inside, it's padding. I think that's what I got wrong, right? Between cells. Wait, I completely forgot what it was. Between cells. I think that's on the outside. Damn, bro. What if I just switch them? Oh, well. Border spacing. Let me get at least one W, bro. Code the first line. Let's see. Code the first line that adds space between text and data cells. What do you mean the first line? Wait, TD? Assess the... I'm kind of lost right now. Add space between text. I'm kind of lost. Let's see. Oh. Okay, well, that's one W. Let's go to JavaScript. But yeah, I mean, I'm really excited right now for the whole new movement, for the new workflow, because GitHub is pretty legit. Like, it's legit, bro. Like, bro, Bitcoin is on here. Really, look at Bitcoin. Ethereum, I think, is on here. Like, A lot of like big companies are on here though. That's another reason why I did it. I was like, this is more official. Also, you can set it up to where you can push from your terminal. Whatever editor you use, you can code, and then you can push your... You don't even got to go on GitHub anymore. I personally will, because I like to see, like, the order. I like to, like, organize my repositories and stuff. Repositories are just folders, I believe. I'm new to GitHub, so I don't really know, but... Yeah, like, Bitcoin's on here. Like, it's official, bro. Occasionally, integers may need to have their bits manipulated. JavaScript provides the necessary tools. Another class of numerical operators are the bitwise operators. Again, introduced in the C language. So there's a lot of things introduced from the C language. Like the increments. This is all JavaScript, right? But it's brought from the C language. C language, a lot of it is. So anyways. Okay, yeah, so I mean, that's pretty much... So the or assignment. I didn't know there was an or assignment. See, I never used this one before. XOR. They just show you. They don't give you like real world examples. But at the end, they do have a... It's a lot, right? At the end, they have a... They have exercises, so I'll be doing those. So, yeah, I mean, that's it. I just said I was just going to read a little bit. I'm not really going to go into it. But what I have learned is, like, numeric operators. Something new, actually, that I learned today. See right here? The incremental. You use this in for loops. You can do it before, or you can do it after. I didn't know that. Also, I didn't know that you can have a negative false. I was over here thinking, why isn't a negative 1? But if false equals 0, negative 0 is still 0. I thought it was... I don't know why, but I thought it was going to be negative 1, because 0 minus 1. And then, true, now this one makes sense, because 1, if you put negative true, true equals 1, negative 1, and so on. What doesn't work, I tried it out, it was, so we have true, plus plus true, that didn't work for me. I don't know if it'll work for other people, but it didn't work for me. I'll try it out right here. Let's see, document. You gotta open up the console. Does this work? Let me see, document right. Oh, no, you don't have to. Because it's up here. Document right. So negative true, this should be negative 1. Let me take all these away. Actually, just have this right here. Negative 1. What about... So if true is 1, plus plus 1, it should be 2, but it's not. So it should be like this, right? Save and run. Is it going to run or no? That's valid, though. That's valid, bro. It's right here. Document right. Do I have to put LN? And for some reason, I don't know. It's just not working. LN, let's see, LN. How about Z? Z plus plus. So that'll do it after. So I'm going to receive. Now it should be 6. Save, I guess. I was going to say, if you put it right here. I don't know. If you were to put Z++, it would work. It would be 5, and it not until you call it after. But apparently, if you use it inside here, it don't work. It should, though. Apparently, it's just this browser right here that is ass. Other than that, though, it's pretty much it. Thank you guys for watching. Peace out.
Even if you are not ready for the day, it cannot always be night. Sir!